Welcome back to the Father's Day Radio Special with your host, Michael James.
Smitty, how do you see being a father being an encourager?
I think the father has a very important role in the family. I mean, I've seen in single parent families where I think it becomes more difficult, and I think it's very, very important to have a male role model in a kid's life. And I think I encourage you. Am I an encourager to you, Anna? Do I make you feel better?
Uh-huh.
Do I love you?
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. And make me comfortable.
I make you comfortable? Well, that's good. Can you tell them how I wrote your song? How it was inspired? You know what the first time that Daddy started playing that song was? Can I tell them? Well, Daddy was downstairs. It was in the morning. And every morning, it used to be every morning, Anna would put on a ballet outfit. And she would come down and start dancing.
And he would play my song.
Right. And one day she started dancing, and I sat down at the piano and started playing this melody. And the only words I had were Anna and I love you. And I got Wayne Kirkpatrick to help me finish writing the lyric. But I wrote the music to Anna in about
little
5 minutes.
Anna,
yeah. Oh, and that's the little part. That's your favorite part. It says,
yeah.
Little Anna, little star, that is what you really are. Cross my heart and hope to die. You're the apple of my eye.
Let's sing that song.
Let's see. Little Anna, little
no.
star. Oh, what song?
The beginning of
I'm just going to sing the chorus. It says, you're my muse. You're my rhyme. You're the fire warming this heart of mine. When you hear me say I love you, Anna, do you know how much I do? Okay. Well, thanks a lot. Happy Father's Day to all the fathers. Can you say Happy Father's Day?
Happy Father's Day.
See you later. Bye-bye.
Is it Father's Day?
It's going to be Father's Day. Say bye-bye one more time.
Bye-bye.
That was Anna Smith, and you're listening to the Father's Day Radio Special with your host, Michael James.
We're kind of all here as a group. I guess one of the things that I keep coming back to is my relationship with my father as a child, how it made me view my Heavenly Father. Man, I run into so many people that in their walks with the Lord that they view God as this guy that's there to punish them and to condemn them for all they do. What do you guys think? I mean, how has that affected your life, your view of your earthly father and your relationship to the Heavenly Father, and if you feel like you could share any of that?
I think to me, the whole concept of righteousness imputed on my behalf is what I keep going back to. I mean, I the Bible says there's none righteous, no, not even one. And to me, that's why the gospel is good news. And I think the way my Heavenly Father shows compassion to me by not only loving me but giving me the righteousness of His Son, that's what keeps me going. Because I know, as well as you guys know, that we are not in and of ourselves righteous before God, but it's only through the blood of Christ. And I think, you know, my father, the way that he loved me and accepted me, and no matter what I was, no matter, even if I were a failure, I know my father would love me. And I feel like those things kind of parallel, and hopefully I can be that to my children and exemplify that through my children, the way my father has to me and the way my Heavenly Father has to both of us.
Both my mom and dad were great, and my dad, I just think, just loved me unconditionally, even when I kind of had a hard time growing up, and he was always there for me. And you know who my father is, Anna? Who's my dad?
I don't know.
You know who my daddy is.
Mm-mm.
Uh-huh.
Mm-mm.
Uh-huh. They live over in Fieldstone Farms. What's his name? You call him what? Granddaddy.
Granddaddy.
Oh, yeah, you knew that. Yeah, Granddaddy and Mimi.
You know, I grew up really, really admiring my dad. I mean, in a genuine way. He was he is He's just a real person, and you know that's something I want to be. I don't want to be fake in any way. I want to be like him. I always wanted to be like him, and you know later in life when I came to know and continued to grow to know who the Heavenly Father is, that's just been such an easy transition. Just I want to be like him. You know, I want to extend grace as quickly as he does. I want to love as much as he does. I want to care as much as he does. And, you know, I owe so much of the foundation that I have in my relationship with my Heavenly Father to my dad, because it's just, I don't know how you do it without it. Of course, that's my life, and thank God that God is God, and, you know, he makes provision for people that don't have fathers. But, man, if we could know the cumulative effect of the good that has happened as a result of fathers in the world, I think it would be a pretty shocking statistic to see the two things compared to each other. But, man, it's just so important. It's the most important thing I will do with my life. I can make all the records I want to, and people are either going to like them or they're not. I can do everything that I have at my hand to do. I can accomplish it all. And if I have not been a good father to my kids, I'm going to consider myself a failure. I'm sorry. I just don't think there's anything more important that I can do.
Well, when I think about my dad, he's a very quiet man, and I think about him not running around and preaching at me. You know, him pretty much living his testimony through his life. In many ways, that's the way Christ was. I think he strove to show that to the world. You know, that I don't think he wanted to beat it over anybody's head. I think he wanted to show this is the way I live my life. And you know, he lived what he believed. That's I'm cool. Certain of that when I think about my father.
That's awesome.
This is my father's world. Into my listening. All nature sings, and around me rings the music of the spheres. This is my Father's world. I rest me in the thought of rocks and trees, of skies and seas. His hand the wonders wrought. This is my Father's world. The birds their carols raise. The morning light, the lily where their maker's praise. This is my Father's world. He shines in all that's fair. In the rustly grass I hear him pass. He speaks to is my Father's world. Oh, let me ne'er forget that though the wrong seems oft so strong, God is the ruler yet. This is my Father's world. The battle shall be satisfied, and earth and heaven be one. This is my Father's world. The battle is not done. Jesus Jesus who died shall be satisfied, and earth and heaven be one. Jesus who died shall be satisfied, and earth and heaven be
guys, I really appreciate you coming out. Clay, Wes, Smitty, Gary, you guys have really been an inspiration, and it's been neat hearing your stories and hearing your testimonies and hearing your heart. And from all of us, we want to say a very special happy Father's Day to our own dads. And Dad, I love you out there. You're a blessing to my life, and thanks for being the godly example that you were growing up and continue to be. I love you very much. And thank you guys for tuning in and listening to this program, and I pray that it's been an inspiration and blessing to you. And on behalf of all of us here out at Riverstone Farm in Franklin, Tennessee, God bless you and happy Father's Day.
That's cool.
I like that. Yeah, that's pretty. Okay, start with me.
You've been listening to the Father's Day Radio Special, sponsored by Reunion Records. Your host has been Michael James. Your executive producer has been Michelle Fink. Creative consultant, Brad Burkhart. I'm John Rivers. Thank you very much for listening, and happy Father's Day.
No. It's too much talk. Go back where you were.
That sounds pretty good to me.
I think it's so smooth. It's really even.
Sorry.
Yay.
This should be better.
Where faith matters most, where family comes first, where love runs deep.
Life is sweet, where love runs deep.
No hype, no artificial ingredients, just the latest from Michael James.
This could be one of these days.
Where love runs deep. Michael James. Just a talented family man with a heart for God and words of hope in a new album. Featuring the hit single, Where Love Runs Deep, the album from Michael James on Reunion.